Hey guys, thank you for joining me with Art Sphere today, and we are going to be using measurements and doing a measurement scavenger hunt with a ruler or a tape measure or a yardstick, whatever you guys have on hand. And if you don't have one of those, I'm using tape measure. If you don't have one of these or a ruler, we do have a handout for that that you can print out on our blog, and we're going to attach the link to that as well. So you could always just print that out. And we are going to be using this measurement scavenger hunt worksheet, where it will give us just different things to find that we can measure. So we have our tape measure or ruler, and we can see the units on it, and the units are just how we measure things. So we have centimeters, which is the small ones at the bottom, and we have inches, which is from here to here. So you can think about 12 inches, which is this long. 12 inches makes 1 foot. And 12 inches also equals 30 centimeters. So 1 foot is 12 inches, and just remember that. And an inch is about 2.5 centimeters. So we go from smallest to largest by centimeters, inches, and then a foot. But we're just gonna be using this to measure in inches each of these things. So we're gonna have to find these things that are listed. So the first one is the length of your thumb, but one of them is also the width of your door. So there's different things that we can be measuring with this that you're gonna have to find around your room. So first one is the length of our thumb. So I'm just gonna measure my thumb, and length is vertical, so up and down. So my thumb ends about here, and it is about 2 inches. So I'm gonna grab a pencil. I'm just gonna write 2 inches here. So you want to record it from where it says the zero to the line and the number. And then if it lands in between the number, you're just gonna count, because it will have 10 little dashes in between for you to count in between. And if it lands halfway, it's 2.5, or if it lands any middle, it's half of that. So the length of the pencil you are using for this, I'm gonna pull mine out. I'm gonna measure by zero, and this is exactly 6 inches, actually. All right, the length of your smallest crayon. I think all my crayons are the same size, but we're gonna do this one. I think I used it a lot. And this crayon is about 3.5 inches. So I'm just recording it here. You also have the length of your arm. So everyone hold their arm out. And I'm gonna record it down from my shoulder. So to the tip of my longest finger, my arm is about 28 inches. So if we think that a foot is 12 inches, 28 inches is longer than a foot. And 2 feet is 12 plus 12, which is 24 inches, so 2 feet is 24 inches, so my arm is longer than 2 feet. Okay, next, we have the length of the tallest book, so you guys can go ahead and find a book for that, and then measure it, write it down. But can you find something that's smaller than 1 inch? So remember, 1 inch is longer than a centimeter, but it's still really small. It's about this big. So you have to look around for something that's less than 1 inch. I don't know if I have anything. I do have a half sticky note, and that might be less than 1 inch. So now we just gotta estimate. This is actually exactly 1 inch, so that's not gonna work for that. I can measure the width of my candle lid, because lengthwise or diameter wise it's long, but if I go from width, it might be less than 1 inch, so we'll see. And it's actually exactly 1 inch, so we're gonna have to find someone else. Huh, this is where it gets tricky. I do have my watch that might be thicker. I have this bracelet, so I'm gonna measure the width of this bracelet. The width of this bracelet is 1/2 inch, so that works for me. So that was a little bit harder. 1/2 inch. And can you find something that's larger than 6 inches? So I do have my bunny down here, which is getting pretty big. And I think my bunny would be a little bit longer than 6 inches because it's pretty fat. I'm gonna measure it if it lets me from the head to the tail. It is 12 inches, right? 11, it's 11 inches. That is what I found for that. Okay. So the rest of them you guys can continue doing. It's, can you find something that's close to 12 inches? And if you remember, 12 inches is 1 foot. Measure the width of your door. Remember that width is this way, so it's horizontal, and length is up and down. Width is side to side, so it's smaller. Measure the width of your book bag and the length of your desk, which I can do right now. My desk is 39 inches. And if you guys don't have a tape measure, because this is easier for me, if you have a ruler and something is long, like 39 inches, all you do is put your ruler down, and a ruler is 1 foot, it's 12 inches. You're gonna put your finger at the end of it and hold the place, and then just move your ruler over. So if I'm measuring my desk like this, I would put my finger where it's 12 inches and just move it. And then you guys can practice addition and add those up. So if my desk was 3 feet, I'd have to move my ruler 3 times, which means 12 times 3, which is 36, I think. So I hope you guys were able to follow along with that, complete the handout, and just practice a little bit more measurement. Measuring is actually really useful when you're trying to hang stuff or set things up or make sure they're straight. And also, as I can chart the growth of my rabbit by measuring how much is growing in inches, or you can test how tall you are by doing that in inches as well. So I hope you guys had an awesome time doing this, and please let us know, email us, or send us a message, and we'll get back to you. Thank you. Have a great day.